Our approach, our goal is to do a 1031 exchange from one property into another. We can't guarantee that because I don't know, what the future holds, but that is our goal. If we don't do a 1031 exchange where they would carry over from one deal to another, or if we have one and they choose not to do that, then just like any investment, they take their money out, get a long-term capital gains tax that needs to be paid. And that's it. That's the end of the deal.
Okay, and then he kind of as a follow-up question, and you basically answered it, but he says, are you taking 5 to 7 year loans on these deals and then planning to refinance and pay out your investors at the time of maturity, or will they remain invested in the deal?
That's a great question because what that hits to the core of is how do you set it up with investors and. There's an interesting point there that you asked about, Dave, where do we when we do a cash out when we do a refinance, do we then cash out the investors or do they remain in the deal? In our deals, they remain in the deal. That is not the way to make the most amount of money in syndication, though. The way to make the most amount of money, in case you're curious, Dave, or any best ever listeners listening, is when you do a refinance, you cash the investors out. And then you hold on to the property. And then, holy cow, you just increase the value of the property to a certain degree. And now you've cashed out the investors. Now you own this property with your business partner 100%. That's the big time way to make, to build your wealth. Now, there are a couple downsides. And the Well, there's really one main downside, and that is it's not as appealing to investors. Because basically it is a debt financing play for investors instead of equity where they have the upside potential. Debt meaning they're investing for, say, 2 years, and you're probably have some clause in the contract where after you reach a certain return to them, plus their money back, then they're cashed out. And I haven't presented that opportunity, that type of structure to my investors, but I suspect there would be a large portion of my investors who are like, wait a second, we've been getting upside on these deals, and I love the refinance, and then I still maintain my same ownership. But now you're saying when we refinance, I'm exiting out of the deal. And pe the people do that, but we haven't structured it that way. So, to summarize, if you want to make the most amount of money and build the most wealth to multifamily syndication, then structure your deals the way I don't structure my deals, and that is cash out your investors on a refinance and then own the whole thing yourself. It likely will be more challenging to raise money that way. Because you're dealing with a different type of investor, but you also might find some investors that only want their money in for 2 years and are only looking for, say, a 12% or so annualized return.